Hey folks, it's me, Cranky V. And today, I'm just kind of messing around. Got all these little projects I'm trying to get some work done on. Here I got my ultrasonic cleaner. This thing come from Harbor Freight. I bought it years ago with a coupon. Got it pretty cheap. And, what I'm doing with it. So I got this carburetor off of this little Honda moped thing. I guess a moped enthusiast would call it a no-ped because it doesn't have any pedals. But regardless, it's a little 1980 Honda NA50 Express 2. I'm doing some work on this for a friend. He wants me to get it running, so I got this little carburetor off in here, and I was just going to rip into it and start spraying it out, but I went to spray off the outside just to get the greasy gunk off the outside, and my B12 wouldn't even touch it, so I'm going to stick it in this ultrasonic cleaner. It's got some degreaser in there, and you know what, I'm going to try to get this hose off it real quick, just a moment. Alrighty, I'm just plugged into this little power bank here because my phone battery's low. But anyway, I didn't want to just open it up with the outside being this dirty because, you know, then that crap gets inside the carburetor. So I'm just going to set this little guy right in here. And since it's so small, it pretty much completely submerges in there. See some air bubbles coming out there. It's got to be filling the float bowl and everything, which that'll be okay. And I'm gonna turn that guy on, and you can already see the bubbles. I got the heater on. I'm gonna put the top back on it because that will get much hotter. I've only had it warming up for a few minutes here. I'm just gonna let that go for a few cycles. That's the thing I dislike the most about this thing, is it's got this timer on there and you cannot set it to go continuous. It's all dusty from doing some paint work earlier, sanding and whatnot. But you cannot set this to go continuous. It does this at most 480 seconds at a time, and I don't know why it does that, probably because it's just a cheap piece of junk. Maybe somebody who's smarter than me could get in there and fool with the circuitry and make it so it could go on continuous, but so you pretty much gotta stay around and kind of babysit the thing and turn it on every few minutes. But that's going. You can kind of see already some junk just coming up in the water here, and this thing actually does a great job cleaning up little carburetors like that. Pretty happy with it. I don't use it very often, but when I do, it's definitely worthwhile. So once the outside of the carburetor's clean, I'll pull it apart and see what the inside looks like and go from there. I may just keep using this and not even really worry about that stuff. I was working on a couple weeks ago was the stressor. As you can see, it looks pretty nice now. The thing was pretty much destroyed. I used this when I was a little kid, and I had pretty much scratched my name and numbers and all sorts of things into the finish on it. And, you know, it looked like a little kid been scribbling all over it, because that's pretty much what happened. You know, I'd take like a metal object or whatever and scratch into it. So I decided to remedy that a couple weeks back, and so that's why I got a little bit of a mess going here, and there's more of the dust from sanding wood and shellac. I decided to go with shellac because it's pretty similar to the color this used to be. I think it's slightly lighter, but I think it came out pretty nicely. I've heard good and bad things about shellac, but I've never used it before, so I wanted to try it out. And I thought it would come out about this color. So, it's the amber kind. There's actually up on the shelf over there some clear stuff, but I didn't want it to look like pine. Yeah, I mean, it's looking pretty decent. Pretty, for the most part, happy with the way it came out. You can't really see it here. The color doesn't look quite right there. Oh, I guess you can when I get close. I may try to touch that up. I think it's just a dry brush stroke there. But, you know, for the most part, I'm happy with it. You know, I spent about a day and a half working on it. You know, from sanding all the old finish off to reapplying. This, you know, this stuff, you gotta wait at least an hour, and then you gotta sand it, and then recoat it, so. And then there's supports for the drawers in there. There's a couple of them that are a little bit loose. I stuck the drawers in there to save space, but I'm going to have to take them back out and drive a couple screws in there. And I've got a little bit of wood glue I'm going to put in there, too, to really sturdy this up. But this thing's almost ready to put back into use, so that's cool. I did have this thing running a little bit just with the refillable aerosol can there, spraying mixed fuel into the intake, and didn't run too bad. I'm not sure if it's because there's no battery in it or because there's no tail light working, but it ended up blowing out the headlight bulb, so I'm gonna have to find a headlight bulb for that and tail light lens and bulb. You can see it's kind of messed up there. Underneath the seat, that's where the battery goes. I've got a battery that supposedly is good for it, but it's not exactly correct. It doesn't have the little square plug. But I have the old battery that came out of this, and that's where I'm slightly confused. I'm fairly sure this is supposed to be a 6-volt system. I was just moving a bunch of stuff, so my car's all pigged up right now. Let's see if I can... There we go. I gotta clean the car out here, but here's the battery that came out of it, and that's where I'm confused. Is this is clearly a 12 volt battery. You see 6 cells here, each cell corresponds to 2 volts, and so if they're all in series, which I've never seen a battery where they weren't, this would be a 12 volt battery. But you know, the more I look at it, that's not even the right plug anyway, so that's not going to help me at all. So, that's out. So I'll have to talk to the guy who owns this. And, I looked this up, and this is for like a newer Honda Elite, like a mid-80s Honda Elite would have had this. And now that I've got it right side by side, these terminals are much, much smaller on here. So, basically... the proper thing to do would be find the correct battery. As you can see on here, these are made so you're not supposed to run it without a battery, and that's kind of why I'm wondering if that's why the bulb blew out. It's just this jumper wire in here that just shorts these two pins. So I pulled up a wiring diagram, and I found that these two black wires are indeed the same wire that's right here that goes to the ignition coil. And so when everything's correct, when you don't have a battery in there, you've got no spark and it won't run. So all I did was take this regular screw terminal, electrical terminal, you know, this one of these guys here, and I just stuck it in there to bridge across there. Now I can't get it back in, but you get the idea. I bridged across there and got spark, and I threw a spark plug in it, got the thing running, and it left this huge puddle of oil on the ground, and it didn't run hardly at first, and then finally it smoked like crazy. So I'm not sure if what happened was all the oil poured through the injection pump and leaked into the engine over time, or if somebody filled it up with oil or what, but I think it's still pretty loaded up with oil. I'm gonna have to pull the muffler off and burn it out. But the engine does run, the ignition system works and stuff, so I'm just gonna get that carburetor opened up, see what I see, probably buy a rebuild kit for it, see if I can get the lights fixed up. That thing just stopped. I don't know if you can hear it on this video or not. But And as you can see, it's starting to, wow, this side actually looks real good. I'll turn it over. You know, it's starting to get the crap off of there. It's just starting to get hot now. So I'll reset this to 480 seconds, turn it back on. And so you pretty much just got to keep doing that with that thing. Anyhow, I guess that'll be about the end of this video, because nothing too much more exciting is going on here. Just constantly working on that piece of junk. Anyway, I might pull the muffler off this thing next and see if I can get the exhaust burned out of it, get the oil cleaned out of the exhaust, and I don't know, I gotta find the fuel and oil lines and stuff. Like this here is good 3/16 Tigon fuel line that I've had laying around because I bought a bunch of it when I was working on my three-wheeler. And so that's gonna work between the fuel petcock here and the carburetor, and for the drain on the carburetor, but it will not work for this oil injection line. I can't really get close to it at the moment, but it's significantly smaller. It's got to be either 1/8 or even smaller than that, but I think it is 1/8. So I'm gonna have to buy some of that, probably also in Tigon. And this is the only one that really concerns me. It's not totally shot, but I don't like it. That's what goes up to the tank. It looks like just a big hose barb on the tank, but as you can see, it's got the little screen in there, and goes down to this smaller size, which I think is also 3/16. But that's more like a 3/8 or even bigger, where it goes onto the tank. So I need to see if I can source this. I haven't really looked for any parts yet, so it may be easier to find this stuff than I think. I'm just going to have to do a little bit of research and see what I can find online, pretty much. But my main goal is to get this thing up and running and operational. You see it has no fuel tank at the moment. That's up in the other garage up there. It's got a lot of rust in it, and the owner of this thing has already messed with it a little bit. He tried a couple different chemicals that are supposed to clean fuel tanks, and they didn't work, he said. And he filled it with Coca-Cola, and he said that worked better than anything else. So I'm going to try that again, and then I might try Evapo Rust as well. But yeah, so that's what I've been doing. See you later, guys.